Now I would like to read out the bio sketch of our beloved principal, Sir Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra. Don't decrease the goal, but increase the effort is the motto of our beloved principal, Sir Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, a recognized academician and educational administrator with the objective of producing the highest echelon of technocrats. His area of interest includes artificial intelligence, software engineering, data mining and warehousing, and wireless network. Professor having several achievements on his name, he is the recipient of Governor Award for 3 times, Rashtriya Gaurav Award, Rashtriya Vikas Ratan Award, Dronacharya Award, Young Leader 2019, IBAE International Award Dubai. He has received rupees 86 lakhs funds from DST IIT Bombay and AICTE. He is also recipient of consultancy project worth of rupees 444 crores from GHMC Hyderabad and 31 lakhs from UGC. He has facilitated 300 Akash tablets from IIT Bombay. He has published 24 patents, 12 books, and more than 88 international and national research papers, 16 magazine articles, and 138 newspaper coverage. He is active member of ISTE, CI, Technical Advisor to Alexia Japan, and many more. Recently, he has been honored as advisor to NAC Bengaluru, UGC Paramash, National Cyber Safety and Security Standards, Government of India. Sir has delivered several guest lectures in different parts of the country, and he is also a visiting corporate trainer for many software organizations. He goes as an invited speaker for higher education conferences organized by TSCHE, that is Government of Telangana, and World's Education Summit. His guidance to all the departments and dedication towards work has taken our institution to heights. Now, may I request our beloved principal, Sir Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, to address the participants. Over to you, sir.
So thank you, Snehalata Madam, for a brief introduction to all. And first, respected Chairman Sri M. Lakshman Reddy sir, respected Executive Director Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav sir, and the iconic personality, the chief guest of today's program, Dr. Darga Kumar, who is a professor of civil engineering department with geotechnology specialization, JNTUH, Manthani, and all the resource person like Bhavani Shankar, Kamalini, then Komu Suresh, and Swamyanath, all these people, and HODs, deans, and organizing committee members, and the convener of this program, Professor Sandhya Kiran, co-convener, Dr. Gyanaranjan Khuntia, and organizing committee member like Dr. Naresh, Mr. Rajesh, Mr. Vijay Kumar, me, then Vanu Prasad, Hemsekhar Reddy, Snehalata, Jasmine, Baliram, Arundhati, Sravani, Anvesh, Madhu Krishna, Gangadhar, Rohini, Prabhakar, Anil, Madhukiran, Venkatesh, Kirti, Mahalakshmi, and all the advisory committee members. Then last but not the least, the participants across the country and the students of this institution and other institution, a very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patra, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you all to this 3 days national level faculty development program, which is titled as Innovation, Entrepreneurship, and its Relevance in Civil Engineering. So first, I would like to appreciate and congratulate to all the participants for taking out your time and showing keen interest to be a part of this memorable event. So looking into the portfolio of civil engineering department, as Snehalata Madam and Sandhya Kiran Madam, both they were narrating to you all. So across Telangana, this is the only department who is holding the highest amount of consultancy project from GHMC Hyderabad, which is worth of 444 crores, which is active for past 3 years. Actively, we are part of it, and the department faculty and students are really doing a great job. And in addition to that, I would like to information to the notice of every individual that recently they have been honored with another 50 crore consultancy project from HMWSSB Hyderabad. So congratulations to the department, and department is NBA accredited, and related to research portfolio they are doing a very good job. And still, if I will remember correctly, then from March 2020 the lockdown was imposed, and on and off the lockdown shut down, then online, all these platforms are different way of teaching learning processes are going on. I appreciate the Department of Civil Engineering that taking all effort and interest, and I have seen that they have taken all effort so that the teaching learning processes is not stopped and also the activities are not stopped. So if I will remember correctly, this is the 9th or 10th online event within a year, 1 year of time, which is hosted by the Department of Civil Engineering. And past all 9s were a very grand success. So I wish this program also should be a very grand success, because I was looking into the portfolio of the different resource person, and it is a blended approach of industry and academia, and definitely all participants will be getting the benefit out of this entire exercise. And as it is all civil engineering, and I could able to past days if we will talk about engineering, if somebody gives his identity that I am an engineer, then undoubtedly he will be a civil engineering, then other branches and all it came into the picture. So the basic origin of engineering is the civil engineering. So that is why always we are having a highest respect to this branch. And really the staff members and students, they are really blessed and fortunate to be a part of this branch, and also those who will be building their career in this particular branch. And the title says about the innovation, entrepreneurship and its relevance in civil engineering. See, there are lot of innovations are happening in civil engineering department. In details, we are going to see all these things from the different. But couple of points and the innovations which is coming to my mind, I thought, no, I should bring it to your notice. So somewhere for some people, definitely it may be useful to take it in the form of a research and, you know, take it to the next level. So when I was reading one article, I came across one technology named as BIPV. And when I started looking into it, it is building integrated photovoltaic glazing. See, in general, if I will say, there is a building, and in the top of in the all the corner of the building, if we will put some glazing materials. Okay, nowadays different kind of panels are there to give the beauty of the building. Okay, so nowadays the research has happened, and what the researchers or the civil engineers have done it, that they have given a name to it. It is called as building envelope. And this building envelope will be integrated solar panel, so that building itself is going to be a self-sustainable mode of consumption of the electricity. So whatever the electricity is required by that building, it will be self-generated by using the building envelope. In return, the building envelopes are integrated with the solar panel. Really, it is a, you know, great idea of the civil engineer to come out with this thought, and also it has come to the reality in many places in India too. We can see all this. And another thing which I liked very much, the green roof system. Nowadays it is very popular, and green system, it's not only like increase the beauty of the building, and also it implements and it gives lot of benefits for the society. And there was a survey conducted. If we will look into the Germany, then whatever the houses or homes are available there, approximately 10% of the houses are green roof system. So that is the beauty of the green roof system, which was all invented by our civil engineers. Then, which is very popular, the concept called plastic roads. In Bangalore also, there is a live model. We can go and see the plastic roads, which are all made to use all the waste plastics and all these things. And the last point what I could able to recall at this point is the eco floating homes. So now you know that the land prices have gone to the sky. So the civil engineers have come out with an approach of designing a floating homes and practically living spaces that sit upon the water and the homes are designed to resist floods by floating on the top of the water using a foundation concrete, which makes them virtually unsinkable. So how good and how great it is, you know, to come out and read about civil engineering, and it looks like some magic book we are reading. So I really appreciate to the entire department for taking out the interest and designing such a beautiful title for everyone. So I am 100% sure that all participants are going to take the benefit out of this entire exercise. So to the participant, the final note is, so this 3 days attendance will be taken of our own software tool, and randomly the attendance system will be monitored. So please ensure that at least you maintain 80% of the attendance to get the certificate, else the certificate will not be issued. So forget about the certification. The first and foremost thing is the knowledge matrix. So let us see, because we are investing time, so we should get some knowledge out of this entire exercise. So the knowledge matrix, normally I say it as horizontal matrix and vertical matrix. These kind of activities and event will give you an opportunity to improve your horizontal knowledge matrix. And please do take care of yourself. As you know, pandemic is going on, so please stay safe. And let us see that the teaching learning processes continues. Finally, wholeheartedly, I would like to thank Dr. Durga Kumar. With a short notice, sir is kind enough to give in his consent, and sir is with us today. So I am going to join all of you to listen to sir also. Finally, so all the very best to the organizer and to all the students and the participants. And have a great day ahead. Thank you for the opportunity.